Welcome to the Tinfoil Rabbit Hole, the show that goes deeper than just the page one search results. I am your host, the White Rabbit. This show comes to you from deep down within our tinfoil rabbit hole. It's from there where we'll discuss the strange, the odd, the mysterious, and the unexplained. We'll explore every subject with its accepted definition and understanding, and dive deep into the interweb in search of alternative possibilities. So I invite you to put on your tinfoil hat and stay with me a while inside my tinfoil rabbit hole. Episode 10, Technological Singularity. Resistance is futile. English author Mary Shelley completed her first world-famous sci-fi novel, Frankenstein, in 1817, just over 200 years ago. The story tells of Victor Frankenstein, a young scientist who creates a grotesque but sapient creature in an unorthodox, mad scientific experiment. Her book may turn out to be eerily prophetic. Here we are, two centuries later. Little does the world know that our civilization now stands on a precipice of the scientific technological abyss, both figuratively and literally. Let's first go back to the Matrix movies. When we watched The Matrix, we thought it as being fictional, just an action movie that portrayed humans as being in separated pods and connected to the machine's artificial intelligence. Those that unplugged from The Matrix were still human biological beings, but they were outside of the machine-controlled Matrix. This Matrix ran simulated programs that each human believed was their reality. There was one generalized reality, and yet each person in their pod was separately having their own individual experiences. This general simulation included the world and all of its people with the belief that everything is connected via the same reality. Inside this matrix, your brain is a separate program within the general program. But once you unplugged or were outside the matrix, your brain was free of both the generalized program and your individual matrix program, so your experiences were no longer controlled by the matrix. Was the matrix supposed to represent singularity, this simulated connection to a common reality? Most research describes singularity as an era in which our intelligence will become increasingly non-biological and trillions of times more powerful than it is today. The dawning of a new civilization that will enable us to transcend our biological limitations and amplify our creativity. A technological singularity is a paradigm-shifting event, a theoretical event occurring when technological progress becomes so rapid and the growth of superhuman intelligence so great that the future after the singularity becomes exponentially harder to predict. Techno-futurists tell us that the exponential development of technology in general and artificial or AI in particular include the complete digital replication of human brains, which will radically transform humanity via two revolutions. The first is the singularity, when artificial intelligence will redesign itself recursively and progressively so that AI will become vastly more powerful than human intelligence. The second revolution will be virtual immortality, when the fullness of our mental selves can be uploaded perfectly to non-biological media such as silicon chips, and our mental selves will live on beyond the demise of our fleshy physical bodies. The White Rabbit strongly suggests that humanity proceed with extreme caution. AI singularity and virtual immortality would mark a startling transhuman world that techno-futurists envision as being inevitable and perhaps just over the horizon. They do not question whether their vision can be actualized. They only debate when it will occur, with estimates ranging from 10 to 100 years. Artificial intelligence is the machine version of the human brain, plus the connection to every bit of information available to it via the interwebs. Artificial intelligence is supposed to be the equivalent of superhuman intelligence and knowledge. The singularity is the connection of the humans and artificial intelligence. So, to take that one step further, singularity is the connection to the matrix, or hopefully to some, the source code or the creator. Is the source code the creator itself? No, it would be at minimum one level removed. Now we go one more step further, out of the matrix, out of reality, and inside the singularity of the tinfoil rabbit hole. It's in there where we will examine the dangers that lay ahead of us if we pursue this technological singularity to its end. The AI scientific research and applied robotics technology communities have mirrored each other in ways that indicate a pivotal and highly consequential project is in the works. Clandestine and creepy endeavors have seen the convergence of all the scientific disciplines and technological advancements which are directly related to the realm of human longevity and immortality. The ultimate goal of this massive and unprecedented collaboration of sciences is to find the proverbial fountain of youth. The power elites who rule this planet we call Earth truly seek the eternal life. They honestly believe that human immortality is attainable. It is in this way that they intend to transform themselves into gods, albeit a notably synthesized version of God. All of this thinking makes the White Rabbit question if there was a hidden agenda to purposefully put the Matrix movie out there into the public. But what if there are those who already know all of this exists in some other form? Theoretical astrophysicists have been saying for years that the universe, at its most atomic level, is binary code. It's all just a sequence of zeros and ones, like computer code. Elon Musk and Ray Kurzweil, among others, have been saying for years that AI is approaching singularity and very well may not be a good idea. The current scientific, technological, AI, and robotics paradigm is headed toward technological singularity at light speed. The technological singularity, or simply the singularity, is the hypothesis that the invention of artificial superintelligence will abruptly trigger runaway technological growth, resulting in unfathomable changes to human civilization. According to this hypothesis, an upgradable intelligent agent, such as a computer running software-based artificial general intelligence, would enter a runaway reaction of self-improvement cycles, with each new and more intelligent generation appearing more and more rapidly, causing an intelligence explosion and resulting in a powerful superintelligence that would qualitatively far surpass all human intelligence. For the uninitiated, it's essential to understand the following crucial key points. The current scientific and technological pursuits toward perfecting AI, especially autonomous superintelligence, are taking place almost completely under the radar, with the exception of a few popular endeavors which have been nicely packaged for public consumption. Needless to say, all parties involved in those experimental developments undertaken under the radar are doing so for specific reasons. Deep down inside, these scientists and theoreticians know that they are currently engaged in a race to reach this singularity. The scientific technological elites have all been aggressively pursuing a specific objective which revolves around attaining human immortality. Artificial intelligence, robotics, genetic engineering, biotechnology, cryogenics have all seen considerable advancement over the past few decades, and more so in the past few years, in the interest of accomplishing this goal. Their essential mission is to fabricate an android biological entity that can theoretically live forever. Their real intention, however, is to infuse this artificially superintelligent and physically immortal being with human consciousness. This is how the power elites believe they can attain human immortality, even if only experienced vicariously, which is significantly different from divine immortality. Their secret quest to attain eternal life in the human body via science and technology instead of through spirituality is what actually spurred the formation of the Illuminati. These self-proclaimed illuminated ones quite deliberately chose the left-handed path in defiance of the Creator. That fateful decision has led to over 240 years of incessant wars and revolutions around the globe. This ongoing saga of greed and lust for power has been portrayed in some of the most popular epics ever written and filmed. During these postmodern times, their futile endeavors are being depicted in novels and songs, artworks and plays, motion pictures, and TV programs more than ever. The movies Blade Runner and its sequel Blade Runner 2049 are examples of repetitive, predictive programming which is always and has been a central pillar of their agenda toward the convincing of the masses that their inventions are good and would make life easier. Who knew that much of what occurs today at the NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory is aimed at completing the scientific technological goal? It's certainly not what we have been told by the media. So are the experiments in particle physics being intermittently run at CERN's Large Hadron Collider on the French-Swiss border? In fact, much of the funding allocated to various scientific research projects at major universities, government laboratories, corporate R&D departments, private foundations, and other participating institutions is actually directed toward fabricating a self-rejuvenating transhuman organism that will never die. The most obvious problem with this ambition is that our present civilization would never be the same should this goal be even partially attained. Nevertheless, the prospect of a super-intelligent race of synthetic androids looms large on the horizon of our future for those hell-bent on carrying out this reckless agenda. The White Rabbit believes that they have not considered the great likelihood that these super-bionic cyborgs, these Frankensteins, would eventually come to rule this planet before they take over the solar system. Then they would likely set their sights on the Milky Way galaxy with the intention of conquering the entire universe. Critics of unbridled AI development postulate that ultimately most of humanity would be sold into slavery and people would become the pets of this new bionic super race. It is said that if there is a prime creator, that he created us, humans, in its own image. So too do the power elites intend to fabricate their Frankensteins in their own likenesses. That's precisely why a super intelligent race of cyborgs would eventually want to take over the world and beyond. The scientific technological class are pawns that merely follow the orders of these wealthy elites. The ones who have gained their power and riches through millennia of warmongering. It's quite predictable that their humanoid progeny would also have a similar mindset. The apple does not fall far from the tree. Forging ahead with wanton abandon toward the goal of human immortality is as perilous as it gets, especially because of who is running the show. The disastrous outcomes of these misguided ventures are both inevitable and preordained. However, you can't tell that to a mad scientist, and the power elites will never listen to the voice of reason. They want to play God, no matter the consequences to themselves or to the rest of humanity. This dangerous mentality, marked by supreme arrogance and ignorance, has permeated every corner of the concerned applied science and applied technology arenas. Each of the scientific and technological disciplines that converge in the pursuit of human immortality has been pushing the envelope. In doing so, the world community now finds itself negotiating more slippery slopes of medical ethics and scientific morality than it knows how to handle. Many of the involved scientists proceed down these dangerous paths, only because the challenges are there. Very few ever stop to ask the question of whether it's safe or right to undertake such an endeavor in light of the many unforeseen and unintended consequences. The White Rabbit warns you, there are many consequences and they are utterly serious. The real problem here is that those who are promoting the human immortality enterprise are blinded by their hubris. They will not see the cliff until after they go over it. Like the story known as the sinking of Atlantis, today's bonding of scientific and technological, political and military, occult and religious elites has put the whole of humanity at great risk. Unless there is a wake-up call soon to nations and people everywhere to make them aware of what's really going on, there must be an earth-shattering event that will be necessary to short-circuit their foolhardy plans. There are now daily announcements about this or that technological advancement or scientific breakthrough in the fields directly related to achieving human immortality. Each of them seems to arouse a growing backlash from those very few within the AI world who know enough to protest and issue the appropriate warnings. The real problem with these developments is that many take place in a virtual vacuum. Whenever DARPA, Bell Labs, CERN's Large Hadron Collider, and NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory have collaborated on projects in the past, they do so as if participating in a CIA black operation. Many of the key scientists know only what is going on in their little niche and particular realm of inquiry or experimentation. They're literally clueless about the many other integral pieces of the AI robotics puzzle that are being ever so painstakingly put together. Since the first computer in 1946, the scientific community and technological class have made it a common cause to attain technological singularity. Why, you ask the White Rabbit? Many people who climb Mount Everest say they do it just because it's there. That dangerous way of thinking is why little or no consideration is ever given to the potentially cataclysmic consequences. During this same time frame, computing technology, peripheral information technology, artificial intelligence, autonomous superintelligence, robotics, genetic engineering, and related disciplines have all seen a considerable acceleration in their advancement. Where major developments initially occurred slowly yet incrementally, they soon graduated to a steadily increasing progression. This pattern was soon replaced by a computative progression of development after just a few years, and is now occurring at an exponential rate. When the original supercomputers were first built in the early 60s, the scientific technological community started to experience an exponential progression in their capabilities to problem solve. Since that time, their progress has seen a steady evolvement approaching a nearly vertical upward trajectory. Now, because of the interwebs, these scientists experience unlimited breakthroughs and advancements. Hence, one can only imagine what the true state of AI is. Given the inconceivable power and speed of computing brain power available today, it was only a matter of when it would be utilized to design autonomous superintelligence. And so they have, except that only a very few have set eyes upon the rapidly manifesting 21st century Frankenstein that possesses such autonomous superintelligence. The vast majority of highly classified work that is done on the various projects which are essential to inventing autonomous superintelligence is done in extremely secret underground laboratories. The White Rabbit tells you his tinfoil rabbit hole is much, much deeper and much more secretive. Those locations are not even on the map, like the super guarded military installations at Area 51 and Pine Gap. In other words, those who are deeply involved with this ultra-sensitive work are never seen or heard from. AI pitchmen like Ray Kurzweil are merely frontmen who are used to ready the public for the next phase of AI and robotics. In reality, all AI press proclamations issued by the mainstream media reflect developments that were made decades ago. Every one of these artificial intelligence progress reports is quite purposefully years behind that which is actually transpiring in the clandestine laboratories. Only the power elites know exactly how close they are to the fulfillment of their dreams, our nightmare. There is nothing more dangerous to the planetary civilization than humanity's naive flirtation with AI. At a time when the world is threatened daily by such things as nuclear war, an asteroid impact, another Chernobyl or Fukushima nuclear disaster, a supervolcano eruption, or an out-of-control virus, none of these looming possibilities even comes close to the total enslavement and destruction to human civilization that comes with out-of-control AI. Sadly, our time in the tinfoil rabbit hole has come to an end. The White Rabbit hopes you enjoyed your time here and invites you to return and visit with him again in the tinfoil rabbit hole.
Where the hell is Tesla?